What's up? It's me, Eccentric Gamer, and it's time for more Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga. We got these two pillars blocking our way, so we can't really do anything. Last time we went to this town and saw a whole bunch of people kind of like dead on the street here, so we're going to completely ignore them and go up here to where the rich peoples live. That's how Mario & Luigi roll. Oh, this is one of my favorite parts right here. Halt! You there! Halt! You can't just waltz on in here! The town has just been attacked, which means the castle could be attacked at any moment! Well, wouldn't they have already attacked already, though? I mean, they just attacked, why would they just leave the castle? I don't know, it doesn't make sense. Lady Lima's instructed us not to allow anyone to enter the castle, anyone whatsoever! Having said that, if you still wish to enter, you must explain your names and your motives. What? You are the world-famous Mario? What? And you are the legendary Luigi? Luigi who? Shh, I have no idea.
I love they're not understanding anything.
If you really are the superstar Mario from the Mushroom Kingdom, then prove it! Bam! Proves it. Right away. The fat jump. No mistaking it! But this guy's really Mario? Shh, I can't be certain. Anyway, what business would the famous Mario and other guy have in this castle? Stop talking. Whoa! I see. Gotcha. What do they want? No clue.
I love these dialogues. This is like my favorite conversation.
Well, that and this one guy we're going to come up with later. Enough. Regardless of all that nonsense, you may not enter. Now be gone. Oh yeah? Boom.
Prince Paisley's Rose?
Are you friends of the prince? Oh yeah, he even did hair flips for us. It was wonderful. You should have been there. This is very wonderful. Listen, I think maybe we ought to let these guys inside. They've got a rose, so it's like, it's all important. We gotta let them in, because they have a plant. okay. It's not like they can't just take it from any garden, whatever, and, I mean, well, although it is signed by him, so I guess he wouldn't keep... Unless he, like, has a garden of autographed roses that he just keeps in his palace garden. I mean, which could happen. So, I don't know. Anyway, okay, taking into account that rose in your wacky story, we can allow you to enter. That was one wacky story. Woo! Alright, now we talk to them, we'll say, this is Bean Bean Castle, this is Bean Bean Castle, we're both robots now. Okay, that's great. Love how you just know what each other's saying. Got wonderful, smiley floor tiles here, and I think you guys just say the same thing, or not. Oh, authorized personnel only, okay. Well, we're authorized. You were authorized enough to get in the castle. We're surely authorized to get through wherever that place is. I mean, we got a rose with a dude's name on it, so that automatically proves our worth. I think, where are we supposed to go first? Oh, we can't go in here, because there's a really weird, ugly, beast-looking door. I think I've never seen that, though, because I've always just gone in here first. Let's make sure, yeah, if we go in here first, I remember. We gotta do this little thing here, and we're gonna completely ignore that person lying there on the floor there, and get this stuff. Because that's much more important than some of the dying. Because we already left those people dying on the streets outside the castle gates. Might as well let one more person start. Okay, fine. We'll go back. Dot, dot, dot. Well, Master Mario and Master Luigi, I can't tell the gender because I can't see who they are. Okay, this is a girl.
That'd be funny if that thing.
Yeah, in case you don't know, there's somebody else in the room that I'm recording this right now. So in case you hear anybody else, just let you know. And just asked where the person came from. The person just came from the room that we were just in, obviously. Even
that was a solid wall. There's no way you could get through that.
I don't know, man. I don't know. I don't know why. I don't know. There's a solid wall, but I don't know how you could get in there. She's bringing up all these weird things about the flaws of the game. Anyway, I am Lady Lima, highest of the ladies at court. The gatekeepers told me of you, and you indeed the Mario & Luigi of fame? The superstars? Oh yeah, this is Superstar Saga, so we gotta be the superstars. Yes, I can't deny that such jumping is the hallmark of the Mario & Luigi of legend. Pardon me? What are you trying to tell me? Oh, do speak up! Yeah, speaking up means freaking out and making obscene gestures with your face! Oh, such ruckus! Speak in softer voices! Now hear me, as you saw... Ooh, she doesn't look too interesting. Oh, okay, whatever. Now hear me, as you saw the town is in ruins and the castle's under strict guard. Yes, we know that. At a time like this, I cannot allow such a suspicious sparrow such as you to meet the queen, but you just said that we were Mario and Luigi. You don't have any suspicions, obviously, if you're certain that we are Mario and Luigi, so... Obviously, you don't care. you know that we're real, and I like that the person just spazzing out on the floor there, just like, nobody's paying attention to the dying person, we're just like having this conversation about whether or not we're Mario and Luigi. Whatever, so she doesn't want us to meet the queen. As the queen's longest serving lady at court, I must act in the interest of her royal safety. Holy crap, trapdoor! No, curses! How there is a conveniently trapdoor. Curses. I completely forgot about that. Hear my words! If you two are indeed the true Mario Brothers, you must prove it by repairing the castle's plumbing. My fast-talking mouth will tell you everything you need to know. If you are able to completely fix it, then you may be Queen Bean. Well then, show me the worth of the Superstar Mario Bros. Now, one thing I'm not going to spoil entirely, but this plumbing is actually an important plot point in the game. Like, you fixing the plumbing is an important plot point in the game, but I'm not going to... The plumbing. You gotta wait. This is the greatest explanation of everything in the world. And we don't need to save, because it's only 6 minutes in the part. I usually only save at the end of a part. I really am digging how, like, none of these sounds are working because this is a really bad emulation. Like, of course, I guess all the ones I found, I tried a different one, but they were equally bad. But right now, no sounds are happening, like, for actions. Only this fluttery sound and the music are happening. And faint other things. Maybe it'll fade in or out sometimes. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna use our newfound hammer skills and then bam, plug the hole. Now that's what we gotta do for other places around here. Let me see where the other places are. Okay, there's another. There's plenty more hammer parts to go though, so don't think, oh, this is it, we're done. But there will be other things we need to do, but a lot of it's gonna be hammering. Beaming Castle Sewers Maintenance Manual, Part 1. Why do they have maintenance manuals separately put on posts around the maintenance, around the basement? Couldn't they just give you a guide? Why do they have to, like, paste, like, okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna have this book, okay? And we're gonna rip... I'm laughing as I'm saying this, because it's so stupid. Okay, I'm gonna try to say it. So we're gonna take this book, explaining everything, rip it into pages, and then put the pages everywhere around the basement, so they have to look everywhere to find all the pages of the manual. Genius!
Can we just put it on the website? No, that's ridiculous.
There's no website. This is Mario and Luigi. They don't have internet, I think. Actually, no, I think that crazy EGAD guy, I think he has internet. Because he's a scientist, so it makes sense. Gotta have research stuff. But even though he's a scientist... Well, actually, I'll get more into him later when we talk about him. But he's... For being so... ahead of the times because he's a scientist, researcher, and has all these crazy gadgets. There's some really odd thing about him that I'm going to have to point out when we get to him later in this game. So we got to whack the stoppers in areas that leak to plug any and all holes. Hey, Lex? Yeah, we already know that. We did that twice. So bam. Hooray! So now then there's no more. The plumbing's all good, so that's pretty good. But what we want to do is let's just level up a bit here because might as well. By the time we get to the next save point, that's probably when I'll be able to end this. So spinies! These are legit spinies, these are not the Sharpies that I found earlier that are named after the wonderful permanent ink brand there. These are actual legit spinies from the Mushroom Kingdom, like, I don't know why they're in the Bean Kingdom Castle basement, but whatever. These are the spinies that you will know and love from all those wonderful Latiku things. So basically, the only way of defense for any spiny enemy, because I've said before, some of the enemies you can jump defense, they have jump attacks that you can only get countered by jumping, and some attacks that you can only counter by hammering, but since these guys we can't jump on because they've got spikes, the only kinds of attacks you can use to counter are your hammer attacks, but doesn't mean they can't have more than one attack, so there can just be different things you can do, but all can be countered with a hammer, so it makes it less complicated, really, when dealing with these guys, because you know you can only defend with a hammer. And you can only attack with a hammer, so you just spam hammer when you find these guys. Ooh, level up! Dude, let's do some BP here. Gotta get some more of that. And money, yes! 3! Perfect, shake that, Mario. Do the dance. Go, Luigi, do that dance too. And what do we need for you? We need stash. Just go, baby, go, baby, go, baby, go, baby! 3! Oh, man, I'm loving this! This is a great part, man. Getting threes all around, this is great. Two's company, but three is most definitely a crowd. Alright, we got stunned him. So yeah, let's get through here. Oh, one thing before, I actually noticed that in the last part, I failed to finish explanation. Last part, I was actually talking about how I used to pronounce Meganium as Meganium. I never completely explained how I figured out the correct spelling. You see, I was watching a show on Cartoon Network, like an episode of Pokemon, where like Gulpins were like eating all the food, everything, and I had to stop them. Officer Jenny just comes out and decides to help with the Gulpin problem, and she says, "Go Meganium." I was like, "What Pokemon is that?" And she sends out what I thought was Meganium. I was like, "What? That's how you say it?" And I was like, "Okay, so yeah." So I always call it Meganium ever since. So that's pretty cool. That. So anyway, I'm recording this right now, New Year's Eve, so there's like a bunch of people in other rooms, but fortunately, they're busy doing stuff like playing Halo and board games and drawing and everything else, so I don't have to worry about too many interruptions unless somebody calls and talks about a board game that's gonna go on, and then we gotta know about it, because it's just the most important board game in the world, and we gotta figure out, like, oh, playing this board game, gotta play it, too. Just letting you know, even though you're clearly busy with something else. Let's just get rid of these guys. These are called Superfly, because they're Superfly. Superfly boys. I dare say they are definitely pretty fly for a white guy. So, if you can't hear that, he's just like saying no. Like, because that was a horrible, I admit it was a horrible pun, but I just really had to. I was going to say fly for a white fly, but it won't make sense because he's not white colored, so whatever. Anyway, we're just going to...
He's not fly, he's not super fly.
That's, he's called super fly, he's super fly, he's called super fly. I really think this is going to be awkward if it ends up that you can't really hear him that well, so it feels like I'm talking to myself, and then you'll send me to a crazy house, and then that would be good, because then I won't be able to make more episodes, and it's not good. So... So I'm trying to be my conscience.
How is that your conscience?
Consciences can tell you to do crazed up stuff, man.
This is
morality. So talking about... Okay. Sometimes people have wicked conscience. What the heck happened? Somehow that froze. Somehow my window froze. I don't know how. It was not my conscience. Oh, jeez. Even this conscience thing. Seems like... I just like doing jump because, you know, I feel like I'm better at timing with jumps. So I feel like that's good to get that. And I feel like I haven't done enough jumping because I'm always doing these attacks with hammer. So I need to get jump in there somehow. And that's where the super flies come in. The super fly. So super fly. Oh, I got a critical with that one. So maybe I am pretty good with the hammer. Just didn't realize it. I'm a poet and I didn't even know it. Oh, I gotta get Mario healed up a bit. Yeah. So anyway, guys, I did Christmas special a while ago, even though it wasn't on Christmas, because I was dealing with capture card issues. This is my New Year's Eve special, so this is the last episode of the year. It's crazy. I know, it's how time flies. And then go 2012, where everybody starts freaking out about the Mayans being right, maybe, but I'm not worried about it, so it's all good. Right now, we're just going to stick with using regular mushrooms because nobody has more than 25 health, so let's just give old Mario some boost here. There we got all that.
What's that wavy purple stuff down at the bottom?
What's the wavy purple stuff? The wavy purple stuff is like the sewer area. It's like some oddly colored... Because this is like a sewer. It's like a basement, it's a plumbing, so obviously...
But it's purple.
I don't know why it's purple. Stop trying to think of these technicalities that I would never think of. Of course, it does make for more interesting commentary. So yeah, go ahead. Think of weird things. The BB Guzzle Sewers Manual Part 2 found more of the ripped pieces of the manual.
What if you, like, found them in the wrong order? Completely messed up.
Well, you wouldn't be able to, because they go up in the order. Like, the room... You wouldn't be able to screw it up and see them in the wrong order, though, because one room has the first one, then the next room has the next one, so, like, unless you just completely ignore it...
Start at a different room.
Well, the trapdoor only leads to one room, so you have to start in this one.
There has to be another way down here.
I don't know. She just dropped me. It doesn't matter. The manual would tell you how to fix the problem in that room anyway, so it's not like it's bad.
Well,
okay, so see, rotate the valve wheel to cue the water flow in the pipes. The valve wheel? That looks like the thing that's stuck in that guy's head and the valve logo. So appropriate. Wait. Completely forgot. We're supposed to do spin jump. And then ba-bing. And then for some reason, it causes that to start to turn. But then, like, the pressure is so great that it makes these things come out. and then hitting a hammer into the wall causes spinies to fly everywhere, and this part is going to need to stop. And for some reason, that Superfly is just so fast that he just, like, faster than all. Yeah, he's like, yo, screw your speed, I'm like Superfly. We got the spinies, kill them. Let's get rid of the Superfly, because he's a threat, because he's got so much speed. Because flies are fast. Spinies are...
I was seriously worried you were about to say swag.
Swag? Why would I... I want to think of a scene, but like...
Well, you were going on with the Superfly thing, and I thought you were legitimately
going
to say swag.
He was going to legitimately say swag. Okay. This is great. I'm so glad I made this episode here, because this is just a great New Year's Eve present for you guys. Totally great here. So let's just kill this guy and get him out of the... Or I could just not hit him. Come here, buddy. Aw, you suck. Come on. Stop being like that. Don't be hating. Don't be hating on the player.
What?
Yeah, if you... That's an instance I first had, like, if you... You can't
that's
win...
Shoddy craftsmanship. Who built these?
Well, like, you're holding the hammer too much. I guess it would start to shake. Because I was saying, in the last part, I believe it was the last part, yeah, where I explained to you the hammer use, because that's when we got our hammers. Or we started to use them in battle, at least. And you gotta wait until, like, before it shakes, but when you No, you wanna wait till after the hammer shakes before you attack with it, but when you're defending, you wanna be able to defend before it starts shaking, because then you could slip off. So there's, like, different ways you gotta think about it. So it's, like, it's in a way that makes it more interesting and complicated in an RPG, if it's not so much so by, like, all the items, because the items don't really make it too complicated as usually it's supposed to. Let's get some HP, I know, because we don't want to do too much BP, or the... If we keep doing them on the same one, as I've said a long time ago, the bonus wheel will have less and less chance to get a bigger number. So, we did, did we do gross points? No, we did stash for him last time, so we can do gross points for him. I think we did. Oh, we got a 4, so, oh, we got 3! We got 3 on both of them, I think. We got 3 on Mario, too, so that's pretty good. We gotta jump up here, and then we gotta put that up there, and then... wait. Shouldn't that have made that? I'm confused now. That's right. I was gonna look around anyway, so I gotta look around anywhere. So, thank you for helping me to save time there.
All right. Let's go find more of that manual.
Yes, let's find more manual. In fact, is there a save point? Because I gotta save this game somewhere. Nowhere. Ooh, what's this? Does this go back to the first room? Oh, we could just go back at the... Well, actually, no. I want to check the third room and see if that... Because that probably has a save point. And if it doesn't, I'll just go back and I'll just be wasting time. But that's okay, because... Whatever. I got another couple of hours to kill for New Year's, so I might as well just do stuff. And I don't see any kind of save point. Oh, wait. Is there a save point up there? Is there a save point?
Crap!
There's... I got ambushed! There are a lot of boxes. I feel like, you want me to introduce you at all, or are you just gonna just kind of be...
If you want.
Alright, I feel like I should, because it'd be just really awkward, like, I'm talking to this person, and you have no idea who it is, I'm like, I'm just talking random guy A right here. Random guy A. But this is, if you ever heard of JackRabbit451, I do have, some videos with him, separately. I am in some of his videos there. Yeah, so he's not a Let's Player, but he is on YouTube. So say hi, JackRabbit451.
Hello, everyone.
All right.
Yeah. Probably should have said that at the beginning.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's the end of a part. Still said it on the episode. You were here, so that's important enough. And we got this going down. And we're doing some mushroom action here. I'm going to put the... Oh, there we go. Oh, you know what? This is 19 minutes. Crap. Should I keep going? Oh, This is a special time. This is New Year's Eve. This is the last me you're gonna see. Oh, that's cheap. That's just cheap. Why would you just
shoot that drops turtles on you? Why did they do that?
I don't know. Why would they do that?
Nothing about the architecture of this building makes sense.
Yeah, I don't know. This is screams Bowser made this, because it explains where the spinies would come from.
No, this just seems like a lack of architecture regulation.
Yeah, so you gotta be careful, like, because Basically, I didn't explain how the spines attack yet, actually. The super flies, you can tell, because they just go faster than the regular flies that we did in Stardust Fields. But these guys, the spines, are different than the Sharpies in the fact that they have two attacks. They can, like, start to, like, do that little... They tuck their legs and their head into their shells, and they spin really close to you, which you can attack them right away. Or they'll kind of, like, appear from go up to a distance from you, which you have to wait until they start to walk towards you, and then you hit them. So... one of them is delayed, and one of them you can hit right away. Like, that one I can just hit right away. But the other one I'll have to wait. It's kind of like the beanies, only without jumping. Instead, we're using hammers. So that's the only difference there. But yeah, this is the ending. I believe that's just going to drop more monsters, so I'm not going to bother. But anyway, might as well keep this going. I mean, this is New Year's Eve. This is the last episode of the year, so... and I've got a special guest commentator, so I don't know. I just do this thing. And also, I haven't done anything for like 4 days, so might as well do something with this importance. Of course, who knows, this might be uploaded on New Year's Eve by the time, God, because this is like 10:30 recording this right now, so who knows. But you guys are used to me doing late night uploads anyway, and you probably won't even see this till New Year's Day, in which you'll think, oh, this is the last thing he did in 2011, and I'm seeing it next year. And then you'll be like doing some really, really cheesy line like, this is so old video, this was made last year. And then I'd be like facepalming until it's New Year's, and then I start doing that myself, doing weird things like, oh, I haven't got it. I'm sorry, I just...
No, don't say it. No, don't
do it. He's telling me right now not to do it. I know I shouldn't. I know that he gets... annoyed with me doing these things every New Year's, mostly because only me and the little kids do it. It's kind of sad, but shows how a kid I am at heart, I guess, or something. Whoa, 15, dang, it's a powerful hit. I mean, because normally I was only doing like what, 5, and then like to get a lucky hit, it's just like, dang. And sometimes I may be referring to them as criticals. I know I did that earlier, this part, but I'm just so used to Pokemon doing, and pretty much everything else does criticals. You don't really have much else. You should just say, if it's a good hit, it's critical damage. Just a standard, I guess, now in RPG kind of things. But these guys like to be different, because they are Mario and Luigi, and they just do that kind of stuff already. Wait a minute. Hold on.
Did you turn the bell?
I did turn the... there's a separate room here. Sneaky devils. Nintendo, you are a sneaky... Ooh, what the... Oh. Oh, okay. I get this. Okay, so it tells me how many more you got left, and this is like a certain turn. Okay, so you gotta do this one first, and then this one next, and then... yeah, that's the order. No, I did it wrong. No, I did that wrong. Okay, so it's this one, and then this one, so I'm gonna do that right now. Get up here, Mario. I need you. It's a game of whack-a-mole, only we are whacking just plugs. And then I'm just gonna do this, and that, and then bam. Hooray! Ding! And now I can use this, switch over Roo over here, and then we can get up here. Yeah. Oh, that's pretty good there. Where are we? Is there a... Jeez, what's up with them not having a save block anywhere? I mean, seriously, man, like... What's going on? Okay, so what do we got here? All right! Oh, I'm so thankful I gotta do more of that, and I gotta go all the way back here to do it.
What pipes weren't functioning until you broke them.
Yeah.
No, before the pipes broke, there was no water coming out the ends. But after the corks popped out, the water started flowing. So either those corks were blocking the entire pipe, or these are the weirdest pipes in all of existence, that they only work when they're broken.
That is interesting way of thinking. I never would have thought of being that so scientific in a Mario game. But yeah, thank you for that insight. I'm glad. This is good. I'm thinking about how odd this is. Now I'm realizing, like, how they must have thought about that. And then it's working again, because we broke it. And now it's... Wow, that was a quick fix. Oh, save block. Oh, thank God. This is like 25... Oh, Woo, thank the stars, you saved me. Wait a minute, wait a minute. We just saw you.
Something is awry.
Citizen Fishy here. Could you be the Mario Brothers from the Mushroom Kingdom? What are the Mario Brothers doing in a place like this? Okay, so basically, we saw you, and then you dropped us down here and told you to fix plumbing. Yeah, what? You claim that I dropped down the pair of you down here and I told you to fix the plumbing? Yes, that's what it said. Most perplexing. Why?
Most perplexing, there are two of you.
Why, we were attacked by Hecleta and our fiends and have been stuck here ever since. Aha! Smell about it. Perhaps the Lady Lima you encountered was...
Is Mario looking at the camera?
Wait. Maybe. No, he's just kind of looking back. Oh, yeah! Foolish Mario Brothers, you have completely and pathetically fallen into my trap. Repairing the plumbing is the key to disabling the Beanstar security system.
Who designed that?
Plot twist, that's the plot twist I was waiting.
No, that's the crappiest engineering ever. Who ties the plumbing directly into the security system so that when you repair the plumbing, the security system fails? This is stupid. I'm gonna go get a cookie.
He's gonna go get a cookie. Okay. So yeah, this is a great part. I'm so glad I kept doing this, because I'm glad that I got to this part and have him blowing his mind over this. I'm blowing my mind over this. I mean, seriously. I mean, you think about it. You've got the plumbing. Anyway, I'll explain after the... Cackletta, it is the hurrying time. We must take that Beanstar and fastly run away from this place. Whoa, dang, you exploded your clothes off. Holy dang. That is the best costume change ever. I want to do that. She just exploded her clothes off. And now, dang, that is awesome. It's like best special effects ever. At last, at long, long last, I have in my possession both the Beanstar and Peach's voice. Ah, crap, so what's that going to do?
It's always stars.
That thing that can grant all desires, the Beanstar. Oh, that's now you talking, okay. We have always remained at this castle acting as guardians, protecting the Beanstar and keeping it out of evil hands. There's no doubt about it, Cackletta must be after the Beanstar. Oh no! Oh, heroic Mario Brothers, quickly now, you must go to the Beanstar, go! You must not let the Beanstar fall into the hands of evil! Quickly, do not dawdle! What's over? Can I talk to you? Quickly, go to the Beanstar! There's no doubt about it. Cackletta must be at the Beanstar. Oh no! What's over here? Ooh. Oh no! Not saving. I'm getting these because after this, I have to leave this place and I can't go back. Is Queen Bean safe? Holy crap! You guys are stuck here today. I'm so frightened at the thought of Cackletta being in here that I refuse to leave. Can't make me. Fine. We won't make you. You can just rot here for eternity. Just rot there. Fine. Do whatever. But I'm gonna go save because this is 27 minutes, so I'm not gonna do it off screen like I always do. So yeah, I'm gonna see you guys next part where we figure out what's going on with this crazy mess, because apparently the Beanstar is linked to the plumbing, which kind of sucks because you either have a security system, you either don't have a security system. Think about that. Think about that. You either have no security for your, like, the source of ultimate power that you don't want to fall in the hands of evil, or you have crappy plumbing, which means that your toilets are going to get backed up and you have bad water. So it's either one or the other. You got to pick one of the two poisons. You got to pick your poison. Of course, I'd probably pick saving the world from ultimate evil over having my toilet clogged. But, you know, it's just me. So anyway, on this note, thank you, JackRabbit451, for co-commentating with this and giving wonderful insight to this that I've never thought possible. So yeah, hopefully I'll get this uploaded before New Year's. Maybe I'll have it like uploaded like a half hour before and you can just like enjoy it then or whatever, or an hour before, probably like an hour before, I'd say, maybe. So yeah, I'll see you guys next part next year, 2012, baby. Alright, it's gonna be a fun year, you just totally tell. So I'm gonna graduate and then all this stuff's gonna happen. It's gonna be crazy. 29 minutes, I gotta end this now. Goodbye.